Okay, we're going to go right to email. Thank you. Thanks for keeping me on track, boss.
That's right.
Okay. That's what you're here for, right? Okay, here's the first question. It comes from Judy, who says, so many people speak of their deceased loved ones watching over them from heaven. Do you think they know what we're doing here on earth?
No, I don't. I don't think that, I mean, you really wouldn't want somebody peering into your bedroom, seeing all the things that you do and listening to all that. It sounds sweet, but I don't think the Bible teaches any such thing. We do know about Lazarus and the rich man. Mm-hmm. And he said, I've got brothers and sisters on earth, but he didn't say he's watching them, you know.
I think people usually think of that scripture in the New Testament that says, talks about the great cloud of witnesses.
That's not the same thing as people watching over you. All right.
Okay, this is Adam, who says, dear Pat, I just prayed with you. This Sunday, I'll be going to church with my wife and kids to be saved and confess to God all my sins. Do I need to confess all I did in the past to the authorities to be fully saved?
No, definitely not. You know, when you come to the Lord, you receive Jesus as your Savior. You say, I'm giving you, I'm receiving you, and I take your death on the cross for me. So, you don't have to go confess. And I hate to tell you, you don't have to go to church to get saved either. I mean, you say, I'm going to church to get saved. It doesn't work that way. The minute you receive him in your heart and ask him to come in and take over, that's when it happens. If you want to solemnify the event by going to church, that's fine, but that's not necessary, all right?
Okay, this is Robert, who says, Pat, I was married to the same lady for 48 years. She passed away and I remarried, which ended in divorce. It was my ex-wife's decision to divorce. I did everything biblically that I could to reconcile, but she wouldn't hear of it and filed for divorce. My question is, does this disqualify me from being a deacon?
Of course not. I really don't think so. I think if anybody holds you accountable, you know, John Wesley was a great man of God. And he married this woman that was just made his life miserable. And she went away. And he said, she went away and I didn't go get her. And I was just as, you know, I mean, it's just that simple. And no, you're not just, I mean, he was anything but a deacon. He headed up the Methodist Church, all right?
Okay. This is John, who says, I pray every day for others and all in the world. I have handed homeless people money when I've passed by them. I didn't give them much, but all I had on me. I'm a simple man and don't ask for luxury items at all. I have prayed for just a small blessing of money to get caught up on a few bills, and I have no luck. To me, $2,000 is a fortune, and to others, it may just be pocket change. I have nobody to ask for help. How can I get God to hear me?
Well, I mean, what do you have in your hand? That's what God asked Moses. What do you got in your hand? I've got a stick. All right, you go and deliver the people from Israel. Well, I've given you a stick. That's all you need. You got your staff, and watch what happens. What do you? You must have some kind of income. Take a little piece of that income every week and put it aside, and then another time put it aside, and then another time put it aside, and you'll be amazing how that money will grow, and before long you'll have your $2,000, all right?
Okay, this is Josie, who says, when we die, do we go straight to heaven or hell, or are we just laid to rest till the coming of Christ?
Well, you know, there's some that talk about a purgatory. I don't believe that's true. Paul said, whether to depart and be with the Lord, which is far better to remain in the flesh for you. There's no in-between, so when you depart, you're with the Lord. Jesus told the thief on the cross, this day you will be with me in paradise. So I think it's, you go to be with the Lord. There are intermediate steps, I think, when you get to heaven, you know, you're in paradise, but there's more that'll come at the resurrection, but we need to get into that. But your spirit will go to be with the Lord, and that's what you're asking me, all right?